Let me introduce you to the brushes that you got with the videos. Photoshop brushes is a universe. Photoshop already comes with a lot of brushes, and you can find thousands, probably millions of brushes online. But in my experience, I never found a brush that was mimicking the tattooing needle. So I tried to create something myself. Probably something better can be done, but anyway, I tried myself and I did this one that is quite useful to me. A few of these brushes are coming with Photoshop. I modified them a little bit just to my needs, and I decided to add them to my set because, of course, these are the brushes that I use the most. So let's start with the soft airbrush. The soft airbrush is coming with Photoshop. I don't remember if I modified or something like that. I use it basically when I don't have any idea. I doodle a little bit, I do something, and I see if anything can happen by chance. Then there is the drawing and coloring brush. I use this one to refine the work or even to sketch or color. It's a very versatile brush and you can use it in many different ways. And then there is the classic airbrush from Photoshop. To be honest, I use the airbrush mostly as an eraser. When I have a clear idea about something that I don't want in my design and I want to keep my sketch loose, well, I use it as an eraser. Or even my design is in an advanced stage and I want, of course, delete part of my drawing. Then there is the filler eraser. The filler eraser, I use it, as the name says, to fill big areas with color, or when I want to erase, to clean my design and to create sharp edges around my design. Then there is the 25 mag that I created. I try to recreate the feeling of a 25 mag, of course, and I use it mostly to do long lines, as I would do in a tattoo when I need long lines. Then there is this 15 mag. This is quite particular. I use it mostly to do hairs and stuff like that. I don't use it really often. The one that I use often is this one. I use this one for about everything. It's mimicking a 15 mag, and even if it slows down the process, I prefer to work with this one because it keeps me in the mindset I need when I have to make a tattoo. Of course, when you tattoo, you don't have all the fancy brushes that Photoshop has. You don't have an airbrush, you don't have all those textured brushes. So I really like to use this one. It recreates the feeling of 15 mag, and so I use it really for everything. So I'm sure I wouldn't add too much stuff or something that is not doable on a tattoo. Then there is the five liner, and of course you would use the five liner as you would use a five liner on your client's skin to add little details or spotlights or something like that. The seven liner is basically the same, a little bit bigger, but anyway, the concept is the same. Then there is the outline. I use this one to outline my work. I create the stencil. When the design is done, I use this one to trace my design and to create my stencil, of course, with black and not with red. And then there is the sketching one. I use this one to sketch. As you can see, it's like using a pencil. It's really soft, and as much as you press, it becomes darker. It's really great to sketch whatever you want to sketch. So these are the brushes that you got. I hope you like it, you enjoy them, experiment, and have fun.